Right now, courtroom tensions are running high in a preliminary hearing for members of a Penn State fraternity. They are charged in the death of a 19-year-old student who fell down a flight of stairs during a night of heavy drinking for a pledge ceremony. Will there be enough evidence for the case to go to trial? Let's bring in criminal defense attorney and Fox News legal analyst Mercedes Colwin and former prosecutor Dan Shore. These are pretty hefty charges. Involuntary manslaughter, a lot of these people are facing. And this was simple hazing and also people just getting drunk. It happens at every college fraternity party. Do they have the evidence to actually prosecute?
That's a great question. I think the judge is really going to struggle because it is alcohol infused. Everybody's their judgment's impaired. You have to show whether it's the assault or involuntary manslaughter that there's a deliberate indifference to human life. How do you do that when everyone is so drunk? They don't expect someone who falls down the five stairs to ultimately end up dead. And that's part of the problem. I think the judge is really going to struggle. Frankly, the prosecutor's like, let's put a wide enough net, bring all of these individuals in, and let's see if we can strike some deals.
So then, Dan, they somehow have to prove that somebody deliberately pushed him.
No, not that someone pushed him, but that they gave him alcohol and they had a disregard for his safety. And the important thing is, in Pennsylvania law, any activity you voluntarily engage in to get into an organization is deemed not voluntary. So if he says, okay, I'll drink to get into this fraternity, that activity is not deemed voluntary in the sense that the fraternity told him he had to drink. So therefore, as a result of that drinking, he fell, they didn't call the police, he died, they can be responsible for that. And the preliminary hearing has a very low standard of proof to move to trial. Very, very low. So they don't have to prove beyond a reasonable doubt yet. This is just showing a basic case.
Couldn't the defense argue when you talk about voluntary versus involuntary drinking? I mean, what frat doesn't voluntarily join so that you can drink? Right. I mean, isn't that sort of, I mean, I know that there's a lot more to fraternities, but isn't drinking sort of the voluntary thing that they're getting into when they go ahead and pledge?
And that's the exact expectation that jurors are going to have. These jurors are smart. Jurors are going to sit there and say, I went to college. I know what frat and sororities are all about. It's about drinking and boozing. So if you're going to go in, you have to be accountable for your own actions. And it's really tragic. It's terrible what happened to him. But ultimately, you may even have jury nullification where the jury may decide, this is really not any criminality.
Mercedes Colwin and Dan Shore, that's all the time we have, but we appreciate you both coming in to talk about it.
Thank you.
Thank you.